And as for his statements, and verily I am the naked warner. The ulama, they say, Imam An-Nawawi, he's quoting Imam An-Nawawi, he's saying, أصله أن الرجل أن الرجل إذا أراد إنذار قومه وإعلامهم بما يوجب المخافة نزع ثوبه وأشار به إليهم إذا كان بعيدا منهم. The origin of this, يعني, and I am the naked warner, that if a man wanted to warn his يعني, and alert his people of a frightful matter to become them, يعني, that's coming to them, he wanted to warn them and alert them of a frightful matter. Now, he will remove his يعني, his thawb, his garment. وَأَشَارَ بِهِ إِلَيْهِمْ إِذَا كَانَ بَعِيدٍ مِنْهُمْ. And he would, يعني, he would motion with his garment to these individuals if they were far away. He would take off his garment and he would motion with his garment to warn his people. Now, he would take off his shirt or his garment, his thawb. لِيُخْبِرَهُمْ بِمَا دَهَمَهُمْ. To inform them of that which was coming upon them and taking them by surprise. وَأَكْثَرُ مَا يُفْعَلُ هَذَا رَبِيئَةُ الْقَوْمِ وَهُوَ طَلِيعَتُهُمْ وَرَقِيبُهُمْ. And the most of those who would do this, يعني, is would be the guard of a people of a town, or their watcher or their lookout. The guard of a town, of a people, or their watcher or their lookout. He will watch for any يعني, armies approaching that town. He will be in the distance, usually probably يعني, maybe somewhere high, looking out for the يعني, for the adu, for the enemy. And if he will see the enemy approaching, he would do this. He would warn his people. He would take that shirt off, his garment off, and he would يعني, signal to his people that the army was coming. And always says qalu, they say in the ulama. وإنما يفعل ذلك لأنه أبين للناظر. And they only did this. Why? Because it was clearer for the onlooker. نعم. وأغرب وأشنع منظرا. And it was more of a strange and heinous sight when you would see someone doing this. So imagine right now, you see someone who's the guard of your town, and you see him with his shirt off, and he's waving his يعني, his shirt like this, warning his people. What's going to happen? The people are going to become alert. They're going to get on alert. So this is a يعني a method يعني subhanallah. This is a method عظيم from the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. He says, فهو أبلغ في استحثاثهم في التأهب للعدو. He said, thus this action is more profound and inciting them to prepare for the enemy. Now, when you see this, everybody's on alert. Everybody's going to prepare for the coming enemy. Now, so now, ikhwan, so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is one who warned his ummah from everything that will harm them and their deen and their dunya. Now, so the one who obeys the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the one who takes heed from that which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned against, then they will be what? They will be the ones who are saved. This is the method, ya akhwan. This is example that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was giving. Al-Hafidhi mentions in Al-Fath. He said, "Qala al-Tibi." Tibi, he said, "Shabbaha sallallahu alaihi wasallam nafsuhu bil-rajul." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he resembled himself to this man, this watcher, and this lookout, this guard of the people, and his يعني وانذاره بالعذاب القريب, and his warning of a near destruction, a near punishment. بانذار الرجل قومه بالجيش المصبح. Now, I mean, this is by this man warning his people from the army's surprise attack. نعم وشبه من أطاعه من أمته ومن عصاه بمن كذب الرجل في إنذاره. And likewise he resembled those who obey him or disobey him to those يعني to the one who rejects the warning of يعني of this watcher. حكاه الحافظ رحمه الله تعالى. So now, so the Prophet ﷺ, he resembled himself, يا إخوان, to this individual, this guard, this onlooker, يعني this looker and this watcher. Now, warning of a near punishment. And likewise again, وشبه من أطاعه من أمتي ومن عصاه بمن كذب الرجل في إنذاره. And he resembled those who either obey him and disobey him to those, to the person, or to those who belie or reject the warning of this washer. And no doubt, again, this is a mathalun azim from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And inshallah ta'ala, we'll end with this. And bi'ithnillah ta'ala, we'll continue reading from some of these ahadith. Kitab al-i'tisam bis-sunnah tomorrow. بإذن الله تعالى هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ويا جزاكم الله خير ويا الله يبارك فيكم
Cats, how you doing, Aki? Everything's good? Everything's good. Everything's good. Everything's good.